Commissioner, one of the things that we hear again and again and again is the idea that, as you mentioned, certainly the police are there, but this really needs to start in the communities and in the, literally in each household.
Oh, absolutely. And this is why, back when we first took office, I used the, if you see something, say something. We don't
right.
need everybody to call and tell us their name, but just call us and give us a description of who has the gun. My officers just last year took 180 some guns off the street.
Mm-hmm.
And through that and through the real effort of the uniform officers and the investigative unit, we've actually cut our number of people shot since we've taken office down by 48%.
Right.
So, I mean, it's important that the people understand. We don't need you to testify all the time, mm-hmm. but we just need your information.
Need the information. Michael, if I could, I'd like to touch on a little bit of other topics in terms of the waterfront. Specifically, we hear, and you see in the news, that obviously Pennsylvania is in love with legalized gambling, and that they have, in fact, decided that they think it would be a great idea to put another, the last, actually, casino license in the South Philadelphia Sports Complex, which is, by my odometer, about 12 miles up I-95 from Harris. What are you hearing about Harris?
Harris has expressed a lot of concern about the license being awarded in South Philly. It could have a dramatic impact on their revenue, which in turn could have a dramatic impact on the city of Chester. So we're watching that, and you know, hopefully, things will go in Harris' favor.
Mm-hmm. What else is new on the riverfront? One of the things that we had always heard about, and the mayor and I have talked about this many a time, is that we laud and support the idea that we have, in fact, a soccer stadium on the riverfront, and we have an anchor team in the MLS, in the Major League Soccer, that calls Chester its home. But we don't forget that when that plan was first unveiled, there was a whole lot more to that plan than what is there now, other than the stadium. Is there any inkling that Buccini and Poland will ever pick up that ball and take run with it again with that original development?
Well, I think they still like the concept. At the end of the day, the math has to work, though.
Yeah.
I mean, for any developer, you have to get a return on investment, mm-hmm. and clearly that's what would drive whether the plan comes to fruition or not. The other area that we're actually starting to pay some attention to is in both Marcus Hook and Trainer with mm-hmm. the energy sector
yeah.
evolution.
Yeah.
We have Monroe Energy and Sunoco Logistics just recently joined. I think with the county's economic development strategy, their 10-year plan is very, very focused on mm-hmm. waterfront redevelopment, energy sector mm-hmm. development, and to the extent that we can kind of play a role in that development of those issues, as well as the Meds and Eds corridor,
right.
that's something that we want to
yeah.
be engaged with.
Yeah. Mayor, you made your stance pretty clear in terms of that the awarding of the last license there in South Philadelphia. What kind of communications do you have with Harris?
Well, first of all, Harris is a Chester entity, regardless of how the names have changed and so forth, and we want to see it succeed. We mm-hmm. get money from Harris for our community. We want to see it work. Actually, that casino is a little over 10 miles away from Harris, which is, it has to be at least 10 miles.
I drive fast, that's
just
why.
They're just a little, they made sure they were just a little over 10 miles. But the water, the riverfront businesses we want to see succeed. Mm-hmm. We hope Harris succeeds. And we've been seriously thinking about how we can help build a community around
yeah.
that area to help facilitate that growth.
Well, one of the things that I wanted to mention in this, and it sort of is an obviously a pattern that's going to repeat a little bit, is that one of the great lures in bringing a lot of this business, especially in the waterfront, was the idea of the KOZ, the Keystone Opportunity
right.
Zones. Well, time flies when you're making raking right. in all that money, and lo and behold, they are no longer in that program. How does that play into, one of my fears has always been, hey, we're going to look around and say, we owe all this tax money now, we better start looking at all our opportunities here.
Well, and that some of that is going on. I think Mike could speak to some of it too, but I think it's going to behoove the city to continue to work with entities like the Riverfront Alliance, at work to establish tax incentives for to get these businesses in here that are fair to the city. I'm for opening the city up, making it a business friendly city, but we have to make sure that the city at the end of the day survives. So the programs, we have a program called the Chris Zone and some other creative types of programs that are coming on. And I'm reminding my council as well that we have to be take the lead sometimes in making sure that we have those kinds of tax incentive mm-hmm. programs that make sense for the city. Right. And we can help yeah. create them. They just don't have to come down from the state, yeah. from the federal side.
Michael, any concerns to that extent that once those KOZ benefits expire that the you know businesses start to you know take another look at their opportunities?
I mean, sure, it raises the cost of doing business, mm-hmm. And they have to evaluate how it impacts their bottom line. Going to something that the mayor had said, the state last year or 2 years ago passed the Community Revitalization Improvement Zone statute, right. which is basically a TIF type of a program. Mm-hmm. And we've been engaged with the county and the city to try to promote that to prospective developers. And really that's something that we've been trying to push hard, talking to the Pacini-Pollan Group and other parties to see if they have significant enough projects that a CRIS type of a program would work for them.
Mayor, I would certainly be remiss if I did not take the opportunity to bring up the fact that there's been a little political news in the city this week. You are, in fact, going to be challenged in the primary by longtime state representative Thaddeus Kirkland, who announced over the weekend that he, in fact, had the support of the city Democratic Party. Were you surprised at all?
No, that didn't surprise me. The thing we have to remember is that we run either Republican, Democrat, or Independent, but we govern bipartisan. Mm-hmm. And I continue to stand on the mission that I had when I came in, and that is to not necessarily put the party over the people. Mm-hmm. And that's what I've done. I've done community engagement, I've done human capital engagement, and getting people involved. And so be it. That's what I said in the newspaper, and that's the way I feel now.
And lo and behold, if that wasn't enough, we had a little more news today that another very, very familiar name in Chester is going to be back in the news. In fact, it's going to be in the paper tomorrow. The Republican candidate for mayor of Chester is going to be none other than former Mayor Wendell Butler. So we'll see how that plays out. We'll go to what we always do at the end of the show. We call this the lightning round. I'll ask a question and we'll go right down the panel. Michael, I think I'll start out here on the right with you. Tell us one reason why you think the surveillance cameras are going to be effective in fighting violence in the city of Chester.
It's a public-private partnership, and I'll go back to what Commissioner Bale has said is it takes the onus off of the residents to report crimes, and it provides a tool for law enforcement, which is exactly what we're trying to do.
Dan, what's the hook for Widener?
Well, one thing I'd like to say that we didn't mention before is that it's not just the cameras that we'll be installing. This will be a network of cameras, so we'll be asking businesses in the city of Chester that have their own camera systems to become part of this network. So if we put up 100 cameras and there's other 100 cameras out there, that doubles our reach. So we have a number of cameras here on campus at Widener that will be part of this initiative.
Okay. Mayor, what are you hoping most to see come out of the surveillance program?
When I came into office, we didn't have a narcotics unit. At the end of an 18-month investigation, our units, along with the state and federal, locked up 40 career drug dealers in our community. A lot of that was done. It was a 261-count indictment. A lot of it was done with cameras. Mm-hmm. That's how they saw them. Yeah. We want more of that all over the city.
Commissioner?
I look to drop the crime rate more and be able to get the guns off the street. We've dropped our part one crimes, but if there's one or two guns out there, it's one or too many. We had 109 people shot. I don't want any shot. Mm-hmm. You know, and that's the camera's going to play a significant part, you know, when they start, you know, seeing their picture in the news or a picture on the media.
Yeah, one of the things that we've been noticing is that you know, those surveillance images in just a very, very short time when we first started using those, they were very, very fuzzy images. Some of the images you get right now are just sharp. And I mean, you've said it as well as we did. Phones start ringing in the newsroom as soon as you put those things onto the website. People say, hey, I know that guy, that kind of thing. All right, We are live from the newsroom. It's every Wednesday night. We will be hopefully back on a somewhat more regular weekly basis. We were off a little bit for the holidays. If you have a topic that you'd like to see addressed on Live from the Newsroom, an idea for a show, or if you'd like us to come out and talk to some people in the community, please drop me an email. I am editor@delcotimes.com. You can always reach me there. We'll be back here on the campus of Widener again next month on Wednesday, February 18th. In the meantime, this is Live from the Newsroom every Wednesday night, 8 o'clock. We'll be back next week. We'll talk to you then. Thanks.